If you want to add a video to your Squarespace website, there are like 5 different ways you can go about doing that. So I'm gonna show you all those ways here in this video. And we're actually gonna use this YouTube channel page that I have here on my website as our example and our starting point. So if you're ready, let's dive right in. So obviously the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go to the page where you wanna add your video and go into edit mode. Now, you can see here, I've got these 6 videos put together in some sort of grid looking design, right? So these are actually individual video blocks. You can see when I hover over them, they each say video and they're their own little blue block. So this is probably the most easy and straightforward way to add a video to your website. All you have to do is do add block in the section on your page where you want to add it and then select video. From there, we'll click the pencil icon and you can see the option to add your video right here. You can either upload a file or select from the library, so something you've already uploaded, or you can add a link from YouTube or Vimeo. I'm going to start by showing you this add from link. So I've already copied a URL of a video of mine and I'm going to click add and you can see it pulls the YouTube video right to my page and styles it to look just like these. So you have to do nothing other than grab that YouTube link and then drop it in this video block. And then you can resize it however you might like. Move it around the page, do whatever you want with it. So that is the video block option. The next option I think is very similar is the embed option. So again, we'll do add block, click embed. You can see it gives us a blank block because we can really embed whatever we want using this block. It's not just for video. We'll click edit and then embed as you see right here. Link is already selected. So we're going to type in that URL and there we go. Same thing. I don't know why successfully located is in red. You'd think it might be in green, but it works right here. Again, just like the video block. It functions the exact same way. So we've got the same video on our page twice. You can see if I do this video block, it gives me the watch on YouTube icon, whereas this embed option doesn't. So maybe that's the one difference that you want to check out. Next up, I want to show you gallery. So I'm going to delete these two and we're going to do add block and you're going to look for gallery over here. Now I'm going to pull it down. So I know gallery, you might think like a photo gallery, but you can actually add videos to these galleries. Again, click the pencil block to add. Upload media here says upload images. So you're like, well, Catherine, it says images, but look, let me show you. If you click this plus icon down here in the bottom right, it gives you more options. So you can search images, upload images, and add video. Same way we just did for the other two options, paste in your URL. A lot of times you can see it says URL is not embeddable and then it will continue to go find it and pull the title for you. We'll hit save and it's right there. Design, if we come to aspect ratio, you can pick one that works for your thumbnails here. This one will get rid of the black and white bars on the top and bottom. You can show titles here. Choose how many thumbnails you want. Padding, if you want it to be a light box or open a new window, you can do that as well. And then you can just drag and drop your grid here. So I think that's a great option. Honestly, I'm kind of surprised I did the video blocks up here, not the gallery. But hey, that's what I was feeling that day, I guess. The next one I want to show you is a little bit different. So it's not actually about putting a video on the page, it's about using it as the background of the page. So if I come here to this section here and do edit section, go to background, you probably most likely always stick to image, but you can actually use video here as well. So let's do add video and I'm going to see what's already in my website library just to make things easy. If I click on this video here that I've uploaded, add that in. Give it a second. Might have to save it and let it figure itself out. The playback speed always comes in at half speed, so I usually speed that up to be the normal speed. And let's see, if we save and exit, that did the trick. And there is our background video. So that is another way to add video to your website. Since this is a live page on my website, I'm going to take that out because it looks a little silly. And the last thing I'm going to show you is how to actually upload those videos to your site. You can do it in a variety of ways. Whether you're using this video block here, like we started with, if I do add a block and then come into add a video, you can upload a video file here. You can see that the file types that are accepted are MP4s, M4Vs, and MOVs, and they can be 30 minutes max. Depending on the plan, the Squarespace plan you have, I think they will allow you more, but I'm on the business plan, so I get 30 minutes of video files uploaded directly to my site. So once I upload a video, say I uploaded a video here using this video block, if I then want to go in to another page and make it that background video, it will be available for me in the library, just like I showed you how I pulled that other video that was already uploaded to my site. It doesn't matter how you upload it, which of those options you use to upload the video. Once it's uploaded to your site, it lives in your asset library and you can use it in whatever way you'd like. I'm gonna save here. Another way that you can use videos, it's the same functionality here, but if I do add video, select from library, add. Let's say you want to have the video playing and looping. You can mute the video, which will allow you to do that. Then you can autoplay it and loop the video. For that, I would likely turn off all of the controls. And I think this is a cool way. Like, I actually played around with this video on my homepage. I had it like set over to the side, add block, with some text over on the right. Something like this, give you a little example. So that way it's just a little something more than having just an image. It takes the space of an image. It looks like an image because there's no player controls or anything, but it gives you that movement, which I think is really neat. So again, something I uploaded to my site and haven't used, but that I did play around with setting it up like this. So those are gonna be the various ways that you can add video to your Squarespace website. Let me know which option is your favorite, your go-to, down in the comments. And I am going to link up another design tutorial for you here to watch next so that you can continue elevating the look and design and feel of your website. So I'll see you over in that next one. Thanks so much for watching.